Hello, good morning, and welcome to Whitey Tells. In this episode, Terry and I head to a D10 exhibition, some recovery work on this VW Transporter. There's an Audi R8 in midweek for some more recovery work, having had a rear-end collision, and then some new car prep. New car prep action on a nitrous blue Focus RS. First, let's hit the road. Right then. Terry, that's light. You've got one over
there. Oh, excellent.
You should be able to.
Oh, that's neat.
We need some directions and we need some. Where are we doing? Rico Arena, Coventry. Hey, how's that technology here?
Straight there, it's fantastic, isn't it?
An hour, 3 minutes, and how many miles?
Did you go through that through Google search?
Google Maps, yeah, it's the app. 65 miles start. I need some audio. Let's have some of this. Ready?
Yeah, ready, let's go. Google Maps, yeah. So what do you do to make it speed?
Welcome to Whitey Tells. Today, Terry and I headed to Waxstock, to Rico Arena in Coventry for Waxstock, which is the biggest car care event in Europe. It's an exhibition of car care, and international guys are flying out. There's lots of professionals from the UK and Europe. And there's seminars going on, there'll be demonstrations. There's like a top 16 category for the top 16 best conditioned cars, best of show, the best worked vehicle, the best new car, the best old car, the best classic car. It's a great event. Today's plan, just mingle, get involved, speak to some guys, see what it's all about, capture some nice B-roll footage, and just enjoy a day out. Hey. Made it, and I'll tell you what, it's a busy one, busiest year I've seen so far. Look at the goosebumps. Just walking off the car park. Now I've been pipped out already. Brilliant. So Waxstock. Waxstock is established in 2012 by the boys and girls. The boys and girls at Dirty Juice and D20 World Forums. The main sponsors for the event are Dirty Juice, is Nanolex, PVD, Valley Pro, Rupes, and Clean and Shiny. And I think this is the third year running at the Rico Arena at Coventry. Previously, 2012, 2013, perhaps 3 years at Peterborough Showground. Always kind of Midlands based, but we're literally just walking around to the main entrance now. Hiya, I'll take it for two, please.
Hey, I'll take it.
Thank you. Thanks.
And you're there. £10 change. Thank
Lovely.
You.
That's a lot. For you.
Thank you.
Very kind.
afternoon. What a morning so far. I very much appreciate the people stopping to say hi, and Terry as well. It's funny, I've been chatting away and I look across and I find Terry's been stopped and people are recognising Terry as well. I'm just with the G10 guys here. I've sold a few of the coated cradles, glancing into those that I bought then. And then we have the Rupert stand. We have Mr. Alan AM Details. Hope we catch him later for a chat. This is the first time I've spoke to the camera. Been here about 4 hours, not had time, but yeah, pretty impressive.
Deep breath.
What a day. What a day. First of all, cheers Ryan, thanks for the mug. Bit of a gift there from Waxstock. I hope that didn't come across really as, I don't know where the video was going. Didn't really get much time with the camera myself. Terry, bless him, ran around, so I got some great sort of third person footage, which is great. This was all I've been really able to use. I didn't want it to come across as a bit of the white detail show or the gym white show. I think that's what it really, I don't know, but it was definitely worth showing the footage. Very humbled by the response and the people stopping to say hello, a great chat. It's got sort of a,
Good morning.
Speak to the devil. Lots of great contacts made and sort of relationships now on Instagram and communications being made. The VDB Transporters here, some rectification work. Audi R8, again, rectification work. And then we have some new car prep footage to follow later in the week. For now, on to the van. I said I want for the money,
a two for the show,
three to get ready, now go, 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 oh, don't you?
A step on my way.
You know it, but it will not be. Midway through day two on the transporter. Come up a treat. Lots of hairdryer scratches on this to be removed and just a general tidy up. Let's have some paintwork on the back end of the rear door. There is just prepping the glass with ceramoxide. Ceramoxide stripping previous glass coatings and any etchings that might be on the glass or little watermarks, that sort of stuff. Paint protection, then wheels, then exhausts, then glass. Then the Audi R8. Final checks on the van. And it's looking pretty good. Back to where it was 19 months ago. So the majority has had a two-stage, pretty much a multi-stage, two or three hits of cutting to remove hedgerow scratches, especially from this near side. Looking sharp again now. There was a series of bad abrasions on these door pillars, all sorted and tidied. There was obviously a couple of scratches around there and someone's had a go with some teakwood or compound. The right-hand rear door has actually had some paint recently, so that's been cut and sorted. And I'd imagine at the same time it's been them. They've probably had a go at the worst of the scratches. Paintwork wearing GTL Exo version 3. Paint protection, two coats off. So a bit of a sweep up and I'll be back in tomorrow to stop this. Good morning. Oh, 5 to 12 already. All I seem to have done is safely washed the Audi. So this car was in, I think it was vlog 24, 25, as the white detail. The rear end's had a collision, it's had a new bumper on it, so it's been painted, it needs fixing, it needs polishing, it needs coating. It's had 4 to 5 weeks of the fresh paint to cure. We start to work out why any contact is bad contact on the vehicle's bodywork. We'll get into the paint condition very shortly, but we're gonna get it airborne first. So with the R8 jacking points, can you see the circle here? That's one jacking point. That just wants to go in the center. Oh, there. Yeah. And at the front, there's a bung. This bung here, this is your jacking point for the front. So that wants to go just about. Audi R8 with brand new paint on the bumper then. Lovely new scratch. Clusters of sander marks here with buffer drawers and all the abrasions and swirls. I don't remember that being there before. On here there is, very difficult to pick up the camera, bit of a flat spot where it looks like it's been caught down. That certainly wasn't there before. Oh, blend marks in the top of the recess here, the registration surround. That's going to be fun. Heavy flatten marks there. Heavy ascending marks there. And way down at the bottom. Hey, so, bumper aside. Hello. We've gained some new scratches. I'm told the bumper was taken off the car to be repainted, but we've got various abrasions and sort of surface defects where it looks like something's caught. Tiny one here. Someone's been rested on the vehicle, maybe. Like a protective mat even. In fact, this scratch here, at the end of it, you see the abrasions around it. A cluster of abrasions, so it looks like someone's rubbed at that, to be honest. And then, oh, down here as well. With what looks like overspray here. You can see how the tone changes from a black to a red or an orange. Marks around the handle. This is the trouble. This is the trouble when cars go for paintwork. You end up chasing. It's not just the bumper that's going to be suffering, as we've seen. It's the adjacent panels, wings, light clusters. So all this is going to be machined up. Sort out the defects, sort out the sander marks. And then these wings will be treated, polished before being coated. And then get the rest of the vehicle wiped down, get the glass, the wheels, exhausts, tyres, that sort of stuff. So it's 12:30 and quite a busy day ahead. I'm still here after telling you so long. Really not a fan of these jobs that you've sort of made it beautiful 110% once already, and I mean it got rear-ended, it can't be helped, it's had to have some surgery and it's coming back for some plastic surgery. But do what you can in the day to rectify for the insurance, for them to pay out, for the customer to be happy, and that's the end goal. So paintwork responding pretty well. There were the cluster of DA nibby marks here, you can see on the very edge. They're still not quite lifted, so I'm going to hit this again. And on the side, you can see it's very much improved until we get right down to the very bottom. and we've still got some fresh sand and mark, so this needs to be chased even further. Got some news for the owner, and I've only just noticed it myself. Once upon a time, this insert, this. Once upon a time, this was gloss black. By gloss black, I mean like this. Easy to scratch, and look how marked they've become already. Yeah, gloss black, solid, no metallic. Now if we look, it's been color matched. So this is now phantom black, I believe it's phantom black. As with the rest of the car, and the underside of it, you can see how heavy and mottled and a bit of a poor respray it is. So once upon a time, gloss black, now color coded. Perhaps not the end of the world, but it does explain why there's buffer trails in the inserts here, because that's not something we want to leave behind when the vehicle is in for its white detail. This crevice, the corner there, that's sort of the worst area in terms of the defect, so I'm going to stick with the microfiber cutting pad before I introduce a yellow Rupes 2-inch foam polishing pad to tackle the rest. The rest of it, I'm thinking, should be improved with foam. Remove all this overspray in the middle there. Sort the buffer trails and the marring and the abrasions, and whatever happens up top happens. So first of all, tackle this with the microfiber and then go over the whole lot with yellow before refining with white. Jim White. The name's White. James White. Think about it as well. Came away from Waxstock having been introduced and met a couple of guys at Detail Kingdom, and this is next cut, next 1.1. It follows up with a refining polish. Can't tell you the full ins and outs of the relationship, but the guy, the mastermind behind, the brains behind the Detail Kingdom operation, good afternoon, what details? Speaking, yes. That was a gentleman named Paul. Paul, nice to speak to you. Reference training days, which still I haven't worked out yet or even thought about, because I'm too busy here. But thanks for the call. Detail Kingdom, the brains behind the operation, I can't probably say, I probably could, but I'm not going to. They were very much involved with the development of another well-known manufacture of compounds and polishes. Broke away from that, started their own thing. So, Detail Kingdom, next cut 101, 1.1, and then there's Finale as well, which is the very, very similar to Menzerna in the viscosity and the even the colour looks like the old 85RD. Let's go back to some now. So yeah, use this on the transporter. Didn't speak about it then, using it now, and getting on great. So with that small section cut with the microfiber pad, same compound, but reducing it down to the yellow Rupes polishing pad. that's the bumper complete at least. Anyway, bit of zoom there, go out. I want to tackle this to make this all one. And then this is sharp and refined. So now we go on to the other panels that shouldn't need work, but are left needing work. Alrighty, wing cut and refined. You can see how nicely it's been refined and worked here. So real nice. Easy working, no filler, no silicon. Very little dust, in fact, thinking about it. Finishing polish, certainly something that I will look to buy myself when this 500 milliliter test bottle runs out. Full wash, and it's always a lengthy decontamination on these. Are always built up with lots of fallout and various forms of contamination. Single stage polish being delivered to the paintwork to prep and cleanse in readiness for multi-layer paint protection later on. You can see on the gloss pillars, the vehicle was prepped by the supply in dealership and it's had a number of washes already. As expected, plastics, the bumpers and the spoilers. Lots of buffer trailing seen here. The wavy lines, the holograms, it's not a true clear clarity. This has been machined, so that's just pure dull bar. And this is full holograms, machine marks. Be right back. After a quick buzz over, with the refiner polish, you can see the clarity has been restored, no more movement, all the defects lifted. Friday morning, just about to start and continue the polishing. Being sent a bit of a gift, a parcel's come through from Sweden. We have 10, those on my Instagram will have seen this already. 10 of the microfiber DA cutting pads, the Meguiar's DMC3 cutting pads. I think they look like they're cut, they've been cut out. But I do know Meguiar's, of course, are, we're told, launching them anyway. But that's really cool. Really cool to have them sent through. Thank you, and there's a little key ring as well. Little Rupes Bigfoot key ring. Seen them before, but never had one. Sent in from Pontus Johansson, and the company is Recond Companiet. Recond Companiet. Appreciated, Pontus. Very kind. By the way, remember the black R8 from earlier in the week? It was part of the insurance. Whoa. It was an insurance job. And the customer having a light for light policy. Spent the last few weeks in a brand new V10 R8 Spider. As courtesy cars go. It's not bad, eh? So the owner's been to pick up their car, and this has been left with myself for pickup later on. I've driven one of these, actually, the V10 R8 Plus Ballistic. The noise, the commotion, the downshifts, the
farts, the bangs, the burbles at the back. A real cool combined package. And I think it's the first time I've seen the Spyder as well. Lots of people always ask, I see the comments in the videos, by the way, I do try and read every single comment, it's just impossible for me to reply to you all. But lots of people always ask, what are the random stripes and the random spare bits of tape dotted around the car? It's literally me recycling the tape for that exact purpose. So the tape I've just used for the pillars, to mask off the pillars, has been pulled from the roof rail, the door rubbers, areas that, ugh, it's still good tape. I know, literally pence worth, but I don't like spending money. Every little helps. Gloss B pillars are the last area on this car to now finalize. With the use of the mighty D-Match scan grip light, pull in some focus, you can see already how many marks and all the haze that's been left on the C pillar on the back door, and then the A and the B pillar on this driver's side. So kicking things off for this C pillar on the offside, although it's a minor, although it's a new car prep and it's a single stage, these, because of how bad they are, a single stage isn't going to cut it, literally. So it's upping it to a two stage. From experience, every manufacturer is different, so there's no whatever I'm about to tell you now. You might try it, it might be successful, you might try it, you might think every car, every polishing set is your own. You have to sort of dabble, experiment and move on. If it works first time, great. I'm still learning, I'm still changing and chopping. In fact, so much so, this is the first time using Netscut Finale on pillars. So using it on a yellow Rupes polishing pad, I've already been around the near side, I've done the A and the B pillar, and I just want to show you this process for this one. What I'm not going to do on this, if you listen to the RPM, although I'm not going to play the whole thing because you'll be here for 3 minutes watching, I'm not going to change it from speed one. So the less heat put into these, the better. I'm allowing the nice oily finishing polish to work with the polishing cut, mechanical polishing of the foam to hopefully remove these light marks. Initial cut looks pretty good. What you do need to be mindful of is this will be a bit hazy. It's when you chase your second refining set is when you want the pure clarity in the results. But I mean, actually it's not looking bad. There might be a few deeper marks here or there, but the movement's gone, the swirls have gone. So now I'm going to jump back to an old friend of mine. This was a bit of an experiment for finding these, and they just work really well for some reason. This is a Dodo Juice finishing pad, and this is Koshkemi M201. I'm literally scraping the barrel now, trying to use the last of. Again on speed one. So there we are. Two polishing sets later, I'm happy with that. It's looking sharp. If I can get some form of protection on here now without the marring, happy days. Looks a bit hazy on the film. I'm not seeing that in real life. Finishing there, that's the focus vlog. This episode, I'm finishing it there. I've got a day and a half left to do on this. The polishing is complete. I've still got the wheels off, where the calipers, the exhaust to treat, I've got the interior treatments to follow, the glass, I've got paint protection.
there's nothing going to happen to this that you've not already seen in previous episodes. In fact, this Focus, this actual car is here because he watched, I think, number 6 or number 7, which is a Focus RS in nitrous blue. New car prep, had the video devoted to that one car. So there's plenty of information back in the archive to go and filter through. So yeah, just to recap, as I say, wish I could have done more with the wax stop content. I wish I could have sort of stopped and spoken to a few people on the camera and given more back, but we just didn't have time. It was an eye-opener. It was a great day. It was very humbling. As I say, thank you to those that stopped to say hi. It was great to see Alan briefly for AM Details. Every time we do this, like once a year, we see each other, but you're busy, I'm busy. We sort of don't really get plenty of time to catch up and chat, but I don't know. We'll see what the calendar holds for the next sort of 6 to 12 months. There is talk of a potential sort of double detail where the two companies, we'll see what happens there. If you'd like that to happen, let us know down below. There was Luke from Tranquility Base Detailing. Great to meet you, sir. And also to Paul Dolden. Details, very briefly, both Luke and Paul have YouTube channels. I'll put their information in the description down below. Before I finish, Thursday this week, I put a post up on Instagram, reference the white details registration plates. There have been lots of comments and questions about these. Where do they buy them? Where do I source them? That sort of stuff. These are actually now available to purchase through myself, through White Details. I put a post up on Instagram, and I think since today is Friday, so it was yesterday, there's been 6 or 7 orders, 2 of which have gone to France and 1 into Canada. In fact, the first email that came through, apologies, I forget your name, but I don't know how the Instagram video came across, but they literally have ordered White Details custom plates to put in the garage, which is an absolute honor. But the idea is, if you're a company, a valeting company, detailing company in the automotive industry yourself, and you have a need to cover up the customer's registration plates on the vehicle, if they're not already being removed from the car, they can be customized to your taste. So what I need from you, the £30 a pair, and they are blue tacked onto the existing registration plate. They're a nice sort of foamy, flexible surface that on sort of like a Carrera bumper, they're able to flex and stick without any sort of rigidity issues. Email me with an email subject of White Details registration plates. I will then sort of find the information and pass what I can across. But I also need your company logo. I need a higher resolution image of that as possible. Any specifics, any sort of special font, any color preferences, the gray background here works quite nicely with the white and the red text. If you want a black background, if you want a green background and yellow text, let me know. Let me know your delivery address also in the email. £30 a pair. Information on these will be down below. I think that's pretty much everything covered. Be sure to find us on Instagram. Check us out there on Facebook and Twitter. Not a lot goes on Twitter. But that's it. Next week, next month, actually August, the month of August, we have 4 weeks and 4 white details. So there's only 4 cars in for the whole of the month. These are 4 restorations, and the first 3 weeks are on one of the UK's most prestigious automotive brands. So I'm looking forward to the upcoming weeks very much so. Hopefully deliver some good content for the vlog. As always, stay safe, take care, and see you in the next one.